Hello everyone, welcome to the video lecture series on computer programming through C programming language. We are in our lecture number 14. Up to our last lecture we learned about what type of operators we have and how expressions can be evaluated by considering the precedence and associativity into our consideration, and also we learned about what is formatted input and output functions, right? So in today's class we'll be learning about what are all the different control statements we have in our C programming language. Now what is nothing but a control statement? Normally the flow of execution will be in a sequential fashion. Sequential fashion means after executing one statement we will be executing the other statement, and then after executing the second statement we'll be executing the third statement. So the flow of execution will be in a sequential fashion. But if you want to change that flow, that means if you want to change the control flow of the execution, then we can do that one by using our control statements. That means we will be having the control of executing the statements, whether you want to execute those statements or you want to skip the execution of those statements. That is your first option. Okay, the second option is whether you want to execute the same statement or set of statements more than once. That is the second option. Or else we have a third option of whether you want to move forward or you want to move backward from the present state, right? So the flow, the control statements are used to change the flow of execution, and that can be done in three ways. The first way is selection statements, where by using these selection statements we will be deciding whether you want to execute a block of statement. Block is nothing but a group of statements. That group can have a single statement or a multiple statements. So selection statements will help us in deciding whether you want to execute that block of statements or you don't want to execute that block of statements, and that decision can be taken. So that can be done by using our selection statement. Okay, so the second category is our iterative statements, where by using these types of statements we will have an opportunity of executing the block of statements more than once. Normally a single statement will be executed only once, but if you want to have an option of executing the block of statements more than once, then that can be achieved by using your iterative statement. That is your second category. Coming to your third category, that is your transfer statements, but the use of this transfer statement is to move your control from present state to either forward direction, that means skipping some statements in the middle and moving forward, or else moving backward also can be done. So in detail about all these selection statements, iterative statements and transfer statements we'll be learning, where by using all these three statements we will be changing the flow of execution. That means we will be controlling the statement's execution. That's why these are named as control statements. Right? So from this lecture we'll start with selection statements first, and then we'll proceed with iterative and then transfer statements. So let us start with the selection statements. Now as the name itself, it is saying like selection. What do you mean by selection? You will be having an option of choosing whether you want to execute those statements or you don't want to execute the statement. That means you have an opportunity of decision making. That means you want to execute or you want to skip the execution. So that's why these are also called as the decision making statements. Like you will be deciding you want to execute or you don't want to execute certain block of statements. Block is nothing but, again I'm repeating, a group of statements. In that block you can have a single statement or multiple statements. More than one statement is also possible. That is referred as a block. Now if you want to execute or you don't want to execute, that depends upon your selection statements, right? Normally we have two types of selection statements. The first one is if statement. Again this first category is categorized into four more types: simple if else, nested if else and else if later. And we have a second type of our selection statement, that is our switch statement. So if statement and switch statement are your two types. Again if is categorized into four more types. So let us learn in detail about all these selection statements, which are also called as decision statements. So in this lecture we will be learning about simple if else and nested if else. So let us start with our First type of selection statement, that is simple if. So as the name itself it is telling, simple if, this is where you will be having one if statement. This is the condition behind that. There is a syntax behind that one. If you need to use, remember all of you, if is a keyword. In C we have 32 keywords. So if, which is all are of small letters, if is one of those 32 keywords. So it should be used as it is. Now after if, you need to use two parentheses, and within the parentheses you need to write down one condition, and you need to use two flower braces, and within the flower braces you need to write down the statements which are all belonging to as one block. So this is completely considered as one block. Now how this will be executed? If it will check the condition. Here you need to write one expression that will be evaluating either true value or a false value. We already learned about what is true value and false value, right? True is 1, false is 0. Okay, so or else you can say another one, the other ways, 0 is considered as false and non-zero is considered as true. So here you need to write an expression with the combination of arithmetic, logical, bitwise operators, any operators, all the 8 types of operators, you need to write an expression, and that expression should evaluate either zero value or non-zero value. If the condition is of non-zero value, which is true, then the control from here, it will go into this block and all the statements will be executed. And after executing all the statements, here is the example of statement 1 and statement 2, then the control will come out of this one, and the next statement, whatever you have after if, will be executed, right? But the other case, if the condition is false, then that means if the condition is 0, then it will not go inside this block. From here it will come out of this one, and the statement will, after this if, will be executed, right? So this can be represented using the flow chart. You can see here where you will have it, you need to evaluate the condition. After evaluating the condition, you have either true option or a false option. If it is true, then whatever code you have written here, that you need to write here, and after that whatever statement you have here, that will be executed. But if it is false, this is the path. If it is false, this block should be bypassed. That means we are not executing this block. The control will come out of this one, and whatever statement you have after if will be executed, right? So this can be evaluated with simple example, like if age is greater than 18, if you are writing a logic like this, then you will get an output of printf, you are major. If the age is not greater than 18, you will not get the output of your major. So let us take a simple example. If you are executing this one in the compiler, if you have written the code like this, where you have asked the user to enter the age, and the age has been stored in a variable called age. Now if the age is greater than 18, if the condition is true, then you will be getting an output like you are major, and then you will get end. If the age whatever you give is less than 18, then this will not be executed. See the test cases here. For the first time, the age value is 19. So 19 is greater than 18, which is true. So you will be entering into this if, you will be getting output of you are major. So you got you are major, and after executing this one, it will come out of this if, and you will be printing end. So end will be displayed. But if you give an age of 16, 16 is greater than 18, which is false. So it will not enter into this if, it will come out of this one. This will be skipped. You will be getting only an output statement of end. Got it? So this is simple if. You have if it is satisfied, this will be executed, or else it will not be executed. As simple as that. We have a second category where you have if else. In the if else, you can have a block for your false option also. The syntax is like this. If the condition is satisfied, that means if the condition is true, then this block of statements will be executed. If the condition evaluates false, then else block will be executed. Observe here, if is a keyword and else is also a keyword. All both are of small letters only. So first the condition is evaluated. If it is true, it will enter into this block of statement. All these statements will be executed, and after executing the last statement of this block, it will come out of this if. Observe the flow, all of you, and it will come to this statement, any statement which is there after this. Don't think like after executing if, else will also be executed. That will not happen. After executing if, it will come out of this block will be end, and it will come out of this one, this will be completely bypassed, and it will come here, and any statement here will be executed. But suppose if the condition is false, then this block will be completely bypassed, it will go to the else part, and these statements will be executed. After executing this one, it will come out of this one, and the statement after here will be executed. That can be shown here in the flow chart. The condition will be represented with the decision box here. You have a true option and the false option. If it is true, a true block will be executed, that is called as an if block. Then after executing this one, it will come here, and any statement we have here that will be executed. If it is false, the condition is false, then the else block will be executed. So there will not be any chance like both this block and this block will be executed. That will never ever will happen, right? One of these two will be executed. So you can see a simple example. If age is greater than 18, if you give an example like this, if the given value of x variable is greater than 18, then this will be printed, or else if the given variable is not greater than 18, it will be printed. Okay, you can check here, the age is asked, and if the age is 18, this your major will be executed, and after executing this statement, you will be getting the end. I'll show you the screenshots of the output. If the age entered is 19, then 19 is greater than 18 is true, you will get an output of your major, you will get your major, and after executing this statement, observe here, we will be getting end statement, no else block will be executed. Right? And if your age is 17, then this block will be executed, this will be skipped, and after executing this one, you will get come here and end will be executed. Right? So now next one is nested if else. Observe carefully what happens in the nested if else is, we all know if and else, and in the if you have one more if else, then it is called as a nesting of if else. Very simple, not that much complicated. We know if else. If this condition is true, this block will be executed. If this condition is false, else block will be executed. Now here, instead of writing the statements, we will be adding one more if else block. Then what happens? Again, this condition will be checked. If it is true, then this block will be executed. If it is false, then this block will be executed. So the flow of control will be represented by this flow chart. Check clearly here. The condition will be evaluated first. If it is true, that means if it is true, then again this condition will be executed, and if it is true, then this block will be executed. If it is false, then this block will be executed, right? And if this main condition is false, then this complete thing will be skipped, it will come out here, and this else block will be executed. You can check an example here. We'll see an example. It will be asking the values of A and B. I have given 20 and 10. 20 is not equal to 10, which is true. So then what happens? It will enter the statements which are there in between these. This is called as if block. It will enter into this one. The first statement A is not equal to B will be evaluated, right? Then it will check. Again, we have if else. So that's why it is called as nested if else. In the if, we are writing if else. Okay. And then it will check 20 is greater than 10. Yes, true. Then this statement will be executed. You will be getting A is bigger than B. Now here, remember one thing, all of you. If you have only one statement in your if or else block, then no need to put the flat braces. Right? You can check the other test case, 10 and 20. 10 is not equal to 20, which is true. So this will be displayed. And then this one is false. So you will be getting this value. And we have another test case, A, both are equal, then yes, which is not true. So false, else part will be executed. Got it, all of you? So this is how nested if else will be executed. Here you need to remember, in if else, in if block, again you are adding if else. Remember that point. And one more point, if you have only one statement, no need to put the flag braces, right? So we have the fourth category also, which is called as else if ladder. About this, we will see in our next video, right? So with this, we will come to an end of today's lecture, where we learned about selection statements. If in that, if we learn about simple if else and nested if else. Let us all meet in our next lecture. Thank you, all of you.